IVM.
Hello and welcome to Waddaplayah.
Waddaplayah.
What an opening from the player.
Yeah.
This is a great week once again.
I have a new jingle for the show.
Which is?
It's called Bole Mere Lips. I love Waddaplayah. I think rhymes are very 2000s.
You know, we're still in the 2000s. No? It's not 3019, Dudeja.
I'm a guy from the future. What can I say? Neon's my color.
The sixth member of Black Eyed Peas on the show today. What a great week for sports. And thankfully, I have both my co-hosts with me this time.
Yeah.
And they're not in Chennai and England like last time.
We recorded after that, you remember, right?
No.
We were all together.
No, I recorded with Joel and
no,
Unni.
You recorded with me and...
Yes, where were you for the World Cup final, Dureja? Can you please recall that?
Do you remember 2 weeks back I was here?
Yeah, no. I'm talking about like the day of a great sports day.
Oh, okay.
The episode
okay.
after
yeah,
a great
yeah,
sports
I mentioned
day.
That. Yeah, like, it's like
I'm sorry, I gave you credit for more IQ, man. But anyway, it was a great day yesterday, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Did you catch everything? The badminton, the cricket?
So, I'll tell you what. I got the India game, obviously.
What a low-ranking event to start with.
Because Ashes, what happened was, I was on cricket info continuously at home.
Huh?
And I'm like, I don't want to put it on because I had a feeling I'll jinx it. Because it's happened a lot of times that there's just one
wicket
left.
Who were you rooting for that you would jinx it?
Rooting bola to obviously for...
You know what I mean, man. You punster.
No, but England only. No.
You were rooting for England?
Obviously, dude.
Bro, aren't you the person famous for putting out the tweet, "Tum log hamara juti ke niche rahega"?
Yeah,
and you are supporting England.
Yeah, because isme Australia sabko juti ke niche rakha bahut time tak.
Dude, come on, man. The guy with the juti has to change. It's been Australia for a long while. Now it's England, and therefore I support Australia.
Oh, but they were one up Australia. You want an interesting series.
Yeah, but like I also, dude, an away team has not won an Ashes since 2001, I think.
2001?
Yeah. No, England won in 2012. This is the same discussion. They won in 2012 or 13 in England.
Yeah.
But Australia has not won in England since 2001.
2001, no. 2006 was the...
2005, England won in...
2005, yeah.
Yeah, so yeah. The previous England series was 4 years before that.
Okay.
So they won in 2001.
2001, yeah. Yeah, so...
I can't believe you watched the India West Indies test. I ignored
no,
that.
Because I was like... that was just on for like... I was doing other things. And it was just on in the background.
The India West Indies.
Yeah, and then I saw, obviously, I put on the Ben Stokes one. There was like one run to win and all.
Uh-huh.
So I put on the TLI.
At what point of the one run to win did you put it on? Because there were so many final points within that point.
No, I did it at like when about to, like he was about to run out. Like
Leach was about to get run out.
Get run out, yeah.
Dude, that game was so...
Yeah, it got too intense.
It was so...
And I had a feeling that the minute I put it on, he was about to get run out. I'm like, this is my jinx. This is what happens when I put it on.
No, our collective jinx got 100 though.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, our collective jinx.
A jinx.
Yeah. That jinx.
Bro, Dudeja, you're damn slow today. Do you need some tea or coffee
or
something?
Hey, man, I was doing some good puns and you're like, stop the pun game. So I became slow in like 2 seconds.
Oh, achha, okay. But let's talk about the Ashes first.
Ashes, yeah.
We'll get back to Ashes later because Aakash is running late.
Oh, yeah.
You should let a kid have his candy, and so we will let Aakash be present for cricket.
Cricket, yeah.
And we will get to badminton straight up.
Yeah.
Did you watch any? Which match of the badminton tournament did you watch?
I saw the final.
You saw the final.
PV, I'm a PV fanboy, so.
Yeah. Dudeja has taken me to badminton matches in the past, and he's like, you know that person is Su Song Wong, and I'm like,
Lee Chong Wei, but okay. It was Lee Chong Wei. That's Yonex. This thing.
Yeah.
All stars. Some masterclass.
Yeah. So I watched the semi-final the day before the final, obviously.
Yeah.
And it's like, it was just some. I have not seen domination like that in a match of a sport I don't follow.
Yeah.
Since like I watched Michael Jordan highlights or Usain Bolt outrunning everyone.
Yeah.
Because there was no competition. There was not a moment of tilt, of balance, of power. There was just nothing, man.
Yeah.
It is often said that in the sport of badminton, the shorter you are, the more agile you tend to be, right? Because you have less body to transport across.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, she translated that height advantage
Yeah, like she has nothing great. Else. Dude, have you seen her strides are like so long? It's like she covers 1/4 the court with like one.
It is not the strides I was impressed with. You know what? Like the player is returning the shuttlecock.
Yeah.
Why are you laughing? I hesitated because I was going to say cock, okay? I'm sorry.
Oh, you'll never be a great commentator of badminton.
Hey, please, yeah. I will convey a more entertaining narrative through my hesitation on air,
cocks.
Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So okay, fine, we'll just say cocks. Okay?
Yeah.
We'll just say. So the East Asian players were returning the cock.
Yeah.
What was the thing that they weren't able to overcome that Sindhu was doing to them was that before the cock can land, she is slamming it above the net only onto the ground.
Yeah. That was like she's taking it mid-air, those shots, like which you would normally a shorter player would take.
Yeah, like, a shorter player would like wait for it. It would at least come below the net and then it would be returned.
Yeah.
But they didn't have the time to react because she is before it, as soon as it crosses the net, it's back.
Yeah, and this like even in the final the same thing happened, like a height advantage.
Because in the final the play was even shorter.
And we need to give Complan some credit where it's due for PV Sindhu's height and
तुम्हारे पास वसाबी है तो क्या हुआ हमारे पास कॉम्प्लान
है वसाबी एंड कॉम्प्लान दैट्स अ ग्रेट कॉम्बिनेशन वसाबी कॉम्प्लान शेक
आई थिंक वी शुड ऑफिशियली स्टार्ट अ पेटिशन फॉर देयर टू बी अ वसाबी फ्लेवर्ड कॉम्प्लान
या
वी हैव फॉर टू लॉन्ग पेटर्नाइज्ड दिस चॉकलेट बुलशिट
या वी नीड वसाबी इन अ ब्रिंग वसाबी बैक टू इट्स ग्लोरी
वन में वन दिस इज नॉट अ ब्रिटिश राज थिंग ही स्टिल नॉट ओवर हिज हैंगओवर फ्रॉम लंदन
गाइस आई हैव जोक नोज़ोमी Okuhara obviously lost in the finals because his name is Hara.
Oh, no one saw that coming, Dudeja.
PV Sindhu obviously won because V stands for victory. Yes,
dude. One minute.
Yes, that's right.
Talking about that. Did you hear the? Did you watch the match live?
I saw it live.
Did you hear the commentary? Because some maha British person was doing, and they. I don't know why they refuse to say PV Sindhu.
Yeah,
they insist on saying Pusala Bank.
Yeah.
And they will never say it like with like emphasis. I'm so used to Ravi Shastri commentating where everything is like, fucking slammed it into the ground and all that. But I'm used to that now.
Yeah.
And this British comedy is like Pusala Venkata Sindhu, the great champion is just playing so well. And the thing is, this wasn't the tone of the match because she was
she's slamming.
She was thoroughly spitting in both opponents' mouth in the semifinal and the final.
Yeah, and even on the coaches of opponents. No.
The thing is, okay. What I found entertaining was that badminton is different from tennis, where the in tennis the coach is not allowed to interact with the player.
Whereas here
the coach sits ringside.
Ab 11 point pe hi ho jata hai wo to pehle.
Yeah, they sit ringside and they are allowed to like give everything. Yeah. So like in a way. A coach in badminton is more a reflection of a player's mindset than in tennis.
Yeah.
And to see, like, I have grown up in the 2000s. I have watched the 2004 Olympics, 2008 Olympics, where China has just dominated and it's like all of them look like the clay statue, the clay army statue.
Yeah.
They're all just the same expression.
What's the clay army statue?
You don't know this.
No, I don't know this.
In Beijing or somewhere in China, there is about thousands of clay soldiers, like human-sized clay soldiers. And I don't know why it's there. I just know that this is there. My guess is, so that they see everyone saying, hey, kya hai? Yeah. So that's the look I was used to on all
Don't you think
faces.
China's done too much to like a hypothetical invasion? Like they are prepared, like they have a wall, they have clay soldiers.
This is how I used to defend my territory when I was a kid with toys.
Yeah.
my soldiers are standing at the border.
Diwar bhi hai. Nakli soldier. G.I. jo laga diye apne.
Yeah. So. The expression I'm used to on their face is a steely look. Like there's no reaction you're going to get from them, which if you're not doing well, is the worst reaction you can get from your opponent because there's nothing to give, there's nothing to challenge. Mm. Bro, her coach was all over the place. Both their maybe in the final it was yesterday. In the final it was less actually, in
Japanese
the semifinal,
people are very calm.
In the semifinal, the Chinese coach was all over the place, and I'm like, oh, so you can crack.
Yeah,
you can crack. This is not. Even a brick wall can crack. You're not something that cannot crack.
Except Rahul Dravid, no one else can crack.
Hey, I saw the white hair on his temple. Okay, please.
So yeah, like I really enjoyed it. And basically, what I've always felt about Sindhu is that, like, I usually would like avoid watching her finals because I see her like get so nervous in the final. I even see like
her third consecutive world championship final.
And she's won silvers, which is actually still not bad. I don't know why people have like
it's not bad at all. But the thing is.
But she just like, she just put out an interview where she said, I'll tell you what the headline reads. This is my answer to those who question me, PV Sindhu.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm just thankful you didn't say Pusala Venkat Sindhu.
Pusala. Yeah.
So what does she say?
Usala victory, Sindhu. That's what.
You should tweet this to her and see what happens.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. Hey, I think it's worth a shot.
Jwala Gatta has replied once to my tweet.
Saying? And what did you say? What did she say?
She was bajawing all politics and everything. She's quite active.
I remember this.
I tweeted, so she replied back some yeah or some shit like that. Some cool thing she did. I like her.
What a newsworthy event today. Thank you for sharing that with us.
Yeah, if I was a celebrity, it would have been like in the news. With pinkvilla.com.
Is Dudeja giving you a taste of his fulfilled life there?
Yeah.
If he were a celebrity, that's how he talks to himself in his head.
Hey, I already am one.
Since we were just talking about coaches, I want to also highlight Pulela.
Yeah, Pulela.
Because they refuse to say P also over there.
Yeah.
He played the role that I saw Chinese coaches play all through the 2000s. Yeah, like he was just Stelia. And the nice part was when she had match point leading 27.
Yeah.
That's when he smiled and he's like, now let's enjoy.
Yeah.
Which
was,
I found that to be very, a great lesson for life that like, do not lower the pressure until...
Yeah,
it's in front of your nose, not even inside. It's in front of your nose.
Yeah, yeah, that's very important. We saw that in two games yesterday, which was even the Ashes.
But like, leave something for Akash. Otherwise, he'll come and say, "Bro, Federer is still playing. What? Hey, Ferguson retired.
What about Thierry Henry?" So yeah, I mean, yeah, that's clearly, and I like, dude, it's just that like I was very happy to see like PV win a final, because every year, even the Olympics and all of that, I've seen her, like,
exactly, that's what I was
she just cracks like in the final. Like,
I don't think she necessarily cracks,
she
man.
Used to, but like I was still a fan, like I like, never questioned her. I was like, just in the final, just chill out. No,
what you're saying may have some merit, because she's lost two world championship finals in the last 2 years, and the year before that she lost the Olympic final.
Yeah,
so logic says she should have won one of those or something like that. And so, yes, there could be a case to say that it cracks. But she is peaking at the right time.
Yeah.
Because it's Olympics next year.
Next year. In Japan.
In Japan.
In Japan. Okuhara, take that. Take that. We won in Basel. Now we are coming for Tokyo.
Yeah.
Correct. Is it in Tokyo?
It's in Tokyo. Okay, I sense the hesitation in your voice. I let you be.
You thought I'll say Kyoto first or what?
It could be, man. Who knows? Osaka also, you could have said.
Oh no, I won't.
You can't name any other city in Japan, no?
Hey, I can. Hiroshima, Nagasaki. Come on, man. You don't know these, what? Read some history, man.
Okay. So it sets up well for the Olympics next year, I feel. And she was
the Indian favorite this time. Like, everyone was like, there's all these Sai Praneet, all these other people. I don't know what happened to Saina exactly. Did she?
I'm not one to say, but like it seems, maybe it's because Sindhu is now like right at the top, she's at her peak, and there's less news space for other names in
the sport. Like, but I remember reading an article which said that in the beginning was that she's the literal, like, I think it was a scroll article or something about like these guys are obviously.
They don't give free press. You have to say Brol.
Brol. Okay. Huh. Brol ka article. Huh. Yeah. That these people are obviously doing their thing. They have their issues, this, that. But this person, she's like our favorite.
Saina, is it?
Yeah. Huh. No, PV.
PV. Huh.
PV, yeah.
Yeah, but that PV's favorite is, it goes without saying. I'm so excited for all the tile ad, cement ad she's going to get.
Oh,
now.
Yeah, yeah. And
if there's one thing you associate with badminton, it's cement.
Cement.
I want to get into the minds of brand people who are like, this looks like a good fit.
Yeah, dude, we should get a better brands, dude. Like, why is Bank of Baroda, like, I don't want to see Bank of Baroda after winning. Like, I'm like, isko thoda nikal do.
I think we should send up some Bob's Kulfi. We'll give them context. So for context, once I was near Dudeja's house one evening and Dudeja said, "Do you want to have Kulfi?" So I said, "Cool, let's go have Kulfis." But where? So he said, "Bro, chill, I'm going to take you to Bob's Kulfi."
Yeah.
Then he took me to a Bank of Baroda outlet outside which a guy stands with Kulfi.
Yeah.
And he's like, this is referred to as Bob's Kulfi because it's Bank of Baroda.
Yeah, man. It's been years. Like, he's been for years.
I love it. I refuse to call him by his real name. His name is Kishan. Who the f*** knows?
Yeah, who cares?
Who knows and who cares? Bob's Kulfi has
Bob's
a better
Kulfi,
ring to it.
Yeah, he's Bob's Kulfi. Yeah, we can all come for Bob's Kulfi.
Do you mind if Bob's Kulfi sponsors?
Oh, yeah. I would totally take Bob's Kulfi. But I want a small like Malai Kulfi ka photo at the end of it.
Like you want a press photo of Bob's Kulfi on the t-shirt, gold medal in one hand and the Kulfi in the other hand.
Yeah, that's also great. Anything for Malai Kulfi, guys. I vote. If there's any party with a Malai Kulfi logo, you have my vote.
Oh, you mean a political party?
Anyone.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
That also, I was thinking, if I have a party, but, I'll...
What, like, you know, every symbol is supposed to have a meaning, right? Like, jhadu is supposed to be like, oh, this comes and cleans and all that.
Yeah.
What is your interpretation of Kulfi, bro?
Malai Kulfi is the most chill thing there is. It's like relaxing after a hard day at work. And it just brings positivity to life.
And no cholesterol, nothing.
No cholesterol, dude. Like, ice cream is made out of some nice dairy. We can do some vegan-free milk also, because I'm
vegan-free milk, like almond milk
or something. Uh-huh. Yeah, not vegan free. That's normal milk.
That's milk. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, because I am an inclusive kind of a guy, you know, so that's my symbol.
Okay. I'm glad that you could say that, since our listeners weren't privy to the conversation you were having on the mic just before this.
Oh, okay.
We let your minds run wild, listeners.
Okay.
Did you watch any of the football? The thing is, I still don't know which teams the two of you all support.
I don't support anyone in football.
No, man. See,
I'm a soft corner for Liverpool.
Do not try to lie to another fellow male that you weren't pressured into supporting a team as a teenager.
I wasn't, dude. I'm Shivaji Park, dude. There was all cricket. We used to look down on footballers because it was all the rich kids from Bombay Scottish who used to play.
You followed,
and we were rowdy public.
You followed Premier Hockey League more than English Premier League, no?
Yeah.
Bro, Maratha Warriors for life. But only in hockey.
Only.
I just want to clarify that.
What about Pune Warriors, man?
Hey, it was some very uninspiring outfit.
I mean, which outfit has been inspiring?
Chennai is quite a lit outfit.
Chennai, even like, I like the black and golden.
The thing is, Kochi Tuskers were too loud in, like, it was full orange, and like orange is not the coolest color these days.
But if you go to Netherlands, it's the coolest color.
No, but they had like orange and purple, which as color combinations go for sporting teams is a good combination. Just that they didn't get the balance.
So you don't like the KKR one? I
like the black and gold. I like the purple and gold. But the purple and gold has stayed the static for too long.
Yeah, for too long. No?
Yeah.
It's like Shah Rukh's career. Dude. Both are static right now.
The best jersey right now in the EPL. Do you have an opinion on that?
No, but you can tell me.
Like, Arsenal used to be the best jersey for a very long time because they had a very clean design and their logo was
central.
They're
called Gunners.
Yeah,
right?
Gunners.
Oh, it's Gunner or what?
Means it's written Gunners, but in the dialect and accent around London, it's Gunners.
Gunners, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a pretty chill. I like Barcelona, like, actually.
Barcelona always has like a funky, it always stands out.
Yeah, that's why I like it. So if you want, I can check out all jerseys and come back on next week's episode and give you my opinion.
Okay, I'll tell you mine, and then you hold everything else in comparison to that. In my opinion, not because I support the team, I feel like Manchester United has a really slick jersey this year.
This year? Can you show me a photo of it, Abhineet?
Do you remember the jersey of 2006?
I mean, if I see it, I think I'll remember. Like,
it was the first AIG jersey I'm talking about.
Oh, okay.
That was my most iconic jersey.
Yeah.
The AIG era was my most iconic jersey because they had the badge around the crest, which was the round logo of the Red Devils.
Okay.
And then it was on a badge, which they have done again this year, which I'm digging.
Okay, I just want to, I'll check it out for now. Can you show me
the jersey? That's the first AIG jersey in front of you.
Show photo. Photo.
Photo, photo. Even the last one, which was the V on the chest. Is an iconic one. I have the away jersey.
One?
This is the goalkeeper's jersey, I think.
Oh, yeah. What is this? Yeah, this is pretty average. I was like, Mikhail, you have bad taste.
Hey, what the bloody hell, man? Today, just because it's an audio show, don't spread some lies, okay?
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, this one.
Yeah.
Oh, I remember this one. Yeah, I used to like this one.
So check out, when you go back and for next week, you check out the current Man United jersey.
And, you know, I like Barcelona always as a jersey. And I also like Madrid, Real Madrid, the away one is the black one.
Yes.
Yeah, because
it changes. For some years, it was like a tealish blue.
Yeah, but you remember the black one? It was really good. Like, I used to really like it.
The thing is, the white home jersey and black away jersey is such a
classic and like a very
it's not classic
wrong.
It's such a, you've taken no risk with your look, man.
Exactly, yeah,
true. And therefore, I'm not going to, like, the lesser risk you take, the lesser appreciation you're going to get for it.
Yeah, in football, if, like, World Cup wise, obviously, if we go about like it, I think my favorite is the Netherlands one.
What lies are you spreading? Do you remember the Nigeria jersey from the World Cup last year?
No.
Bro, that is a fashion statement.
Yeah,
that
I
is
just love
a fashion.
Orange. Way too much. Outside India.
I mean, just pull up the Nigeria 2018 World Cup jersey and let's see Dudeja's reaction. This has now transitioned into a sports fashion show. It started with Bank of Baroda, actually, if I recall correct.
Bob the Kulfi. Khaake dikhayenge. Oh, this one. Yeah, I remember. Yeah. This is also
it was lit.
Even Croatia had the same.
Croatia always has the checkered thing.
The checkered
thing.
Feel, right?
But yeah. Nigeria was a particular outlier with a step up in their jersey game.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Anyway, before we carry on, let's please go into a break. And I have one announcement before that. If you enjoyed our conversation, it sounds like you enjoy sports being spoken about in your vicinity, which is why you should tune in to our two football podcasts, Football Shootball and Football Twaddle, every Wednesday on the IVM Network. You should check it out. I highly recommend it. And if you don't want to watch it, come back for the second segment of our show. At the very least, please. Yeah, cool. I'll see you after.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another awesome week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you are not following us on social media, please make sure you do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And also, just a reminder, if you like what you're listening to, take a screenshot of what you're listening to and tag us on social media, and we will repost your post. Also, please do tell a friend if you're enjoying a podcast which you think a friend would enjoy. Do tell them. I think that that is something that really helps us. I think that we do see, you know, I mean, like increases in listenerships when you guys do that. So please, please do tell friends that you are enjoying what podcast you're listening to. Last week, we launched a new show called Agla Station Adulthood with best friends Ritasha Rathod and Ayushi Amin. They talk about their journey into adulthood. On the first episode, they discuss crushes and female friendships. And on this week's episode, they try to crack the code on how to adult. You can also catch Ritasha and Ayushi on this week's Cyrus Says, where they talk to Cyrus about the podcast, what constitutes acting like a grown-up, and Ritasha gives Cyrus detailed instructions to reach Mud Island. On The Seen and the Unseen, Amit Verma is in conversation with economist Mohit Satyanand about what constitutes the economic crisis. On Waddaplayah, Aakash and Siddharth are joined by fellow comedian Harmanpreet Singh. They talk about fast bowler Jofra Archer, the India-West Indies series, Ravi Shastri getting reappointed as coach, and a whole lot more. On the Edges and Sledges Cricket Podcast, Ashwin, DJ and Varun discuss the gale storm, Shreyas Iyer's beautiful knock, Virat Kohli striking a century, Steve Smith's injury, and a lot more. On The Origin of Things, Chuck narrates a short story about an old brand. It might just be the shortest podcast in IVM history. Check it out. On Marbles Lost and Found, Zen and Avanti are joined by podcast producer Janam Divan for part two of Dealing with Grief and Loss. On Mr. and Mrs. Binge Watch, Anirudh and Janice discuss Netflix originals Glow and Orange is the New Black, which are back with new seasons. On Keeping It Queer, Naveen and Farah talk about the differences and similarities between gay dating and straight dating. Their guest is Manshir Singh, a writer and web series creator. On our Kannada podcast, Thale Arate, Dr. Chandan Gowda joins Surya and Pawan for a conversation on the cultural politics of development in Mysore. This week on the Filter Coffee podcast, Karthik Nagarajan talks to the founder of Kriya, Praveen Shekhar, about professional speaking. And with that, let's get you on with your show.
All right, guys, we are back on Waddaplayah. I hope you're still stuck in traffic. And please buy an umbrella from the guy who's selling it to you.
Or tissue paper.
Or tissue paper.
Or pen caps.
Yes, yeah, pen and caps. That is the voice of Aakash, who has made it here.
Yeah.
Just in time for cricket.
Yes. Just in time.
Oops.
That's a shock.
Actually, I was there like 10 minutes back, but they were too busy talking about whatever they were talking about. All this football, shootball, hi Rabba.
Why are you dissing the sister podcast on this network?
Yeah.
Oh no, I thought football, shootball, hi Rabba is like a movie reference.
Yeah.
It was the title of Bend It Like Beckham in Hindi.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
Yeah.
I was not talking about the sister podcast, man. Don't put things on me like that.
Do you remember Dunstan, what? Dunstan Checkson. Ek bandar hotel ke andar.
Dudeja, sometimes you really need to give context on what goes on in your head.
No, like you're talking about Hindi names, right?
Yeah.
So Dunstan Checkson is a movie, right?
Is it?
I don't know of it.
Yeah, it was like this when we were small. It was basically about a monkey.
I'm so
all.
Glad we have Dudeja on the podcast for the five niche listeners who get all his references.
Ek bandar
hotel
ke andar.
Those guys must love this podcast.
Those are the only people listening to this
look
podcast.
Look at that. Look at the photos. It was actually, and who was the actor in it?
Oh, Dunstan checks
in. Yeah,
you Dunstan made it sound like it's a full Dunstan name Checkson. Called Dunstan checks in. I'm like, Dunstan who's this Checkson. Person who has no experience in naming names?
No, Dunstan checks in, but in Hindi it's called Ek Bandar Hotel Ke Andar.
But in Fast and the Furious was called Raftar Ka Junoon.
Junoon, ah.
Yeah, so oh, it's cool. Shit.
Raftar Ke Junoon is anything.
Did you ever
Junoon?
Watch a dubbed movie, Hindi dubbed movie?
I used to watch Spider-Man when
Spider-Man
it was aired in Hindi.
Oh,
I've seen Spider-Man in Hindi.
And I recently tried to watch some movie, some English movie in Hindi. And you know what? I figured what the problem is. The problem is that while you get the translation correct, earlier it was even the translation that used to be a problem, that you don't account for tone and things like that.
Yeah.
Now, the energy with which a line is delivered in English is not being delivered in Hindi.
Yeah.
So you're getting, your meaning is right, the scripts match, but the delivery is just horrible. So I was watching Deadpool promo in Hindi. It has some 9 million views for how bad it is.
The Deadpool movie in Hindi was great. The first Deadpool. It was really
did Ranveer Singh dub it?
Then I watched Harry Potter Chamber of Secrets by mistake in Hindi because I was tricked into it by my uncle.
I just hope that's the only thing you were tricked into by your uncle.
Only time will tell.
Time has already told. Only you will tell with time.
For such stories, listen to Vartalab. And then I watched Conjuring 2 in Hindi.
What was it called in Hindi?
It was called Conjuring 2.
Is it Conjuring Mark? No.
Let's get to cricket. It's a sports podcast.
Great weekend in cricket, you guys.
Yes. Great weekend in cricket. Did you watch it live?
Which one?
The Ashes.
Ashes, I told you, right?
You were watching India Westernies and only the last minute you tuned in. I'm sure you watched it live.
I watched it live while Kautuk Shriyastav did 5 extra minutes so that I could watch it live.
Oh wow. That's commitment.
That's mad. Yeah. Did you reference it when you went on stage after the thing?
No, I didn't tell them. I said the Ashes match has been finished and they were like, who won? And I'm like, I'm not telling you.
Oh yeah, that's a respectable move.
Yeah.
But let's get to the nitty gritty of it. Bro, like, I didn't watch it live. I watched until 60 runs were needed to win, and then I was at a place where it was rude to watch the match.
Right. Where is this?
I was with a friend who doesn't follow the sport, man.
Okay,
so like,
then it's fine.
It was a date, I think.
Yeah,
it was a friend, but like, this context applies to a date as well, right? Okay, like, in a social situation, it's sometimes considered rude to watch.
No, I thought, I'm being real with you from day one. I need to watch this.
I'm being real with you on day one, day two, day three, day four, day five, and then over.
No, okay, I don't want to start with discussing the very last session or the very last day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was your graph of emotions through the match?
So all this was one of those like ek to hai na dekho jab barish nahi aata to kitna mast cricket khel sakte kitna mast cricket hota hai
wo to abhi global warming ke wajah se hum log bahut acha cricket khelenge kyunki barish kam aa gayi.
There is there was like that second the first innings for England batting, it was amazing to watch Jofra Archer. I don't know if you saw the tweet that
Bumrah, first innings of England batting
where
they got 67.
Yeah, they're 45 for 5.
And so I'm saying that was one highlight, and the other highlight was watching Jofra bowl.
Where he took the 5-4.
Yeah,
yeah.
The 6-4.
No. Forget the 5 and the 6. Every innings he's bowling, it's like watching a fucking miracle, dude.
Yes, but which is why when he limped off in the second innings, I was like, bro, this is mad. I want Australia to win, bro.
Why you were rooting for Australia?
I was rooting for Australia.
What?
I'll tell you why. I was rooting for Australia until let's not forget the first 4 days, okay?
Hey, what? Forget the first 4 days? Just because the last day was too good, let's not forget that.
So
the first
I'll tell
day
you,
also,
day four, I was like when they were 120 or 100.
It was day, the last day was day four, right? The match was scheduled to end Monday, which is today when we're recording.
Yeah, but like basically when day three, I was like, dude, this looks very much possible when they were 120 or 100 for 2 or something. And then my friend's like, dude, you don't understand test cricket or what? Like, one wicket will fall, then it'll all go away.
But that is the way it works. Why are you mocking your friend for speaking the truth?
No, but I was like, अंदर तो आशा तो रहती है ना हर इंसान के कि भाई मेरी टीम जीत जाए और मेरे अंदर आशा थी और मैं सही निकला.
Why did you Sanskritize yourself so much just now?
Yaar,
there is usme kya hai, I wanted Australia to win just by virtue ki bas ye wala series mein main Australia ko support kar raha hai jitna chahiye.
Yeah, it's a temporary support.
But then when you watch Ben Stokes
dude, you know at what point my ears went up in at the end of England's second innings first day, when they went in at stumps, Joe Root and Ben Stokes were at the crease. What got my ears up was that Ben Stokes at the end of that day was batting on 2 from 50 balls.
I was like really
bro,
slow.
Bro, if this guy is this dogged, this match can go down.
He's gonna do it.
I am not ruling out because usually I would have ruled it out.
He changed gears when needed.
If you were 2 or 3 wickets down with another 300 or something required or 250 required, I would be like, this is out. But like, if a person as naturally aggressive as Ben Stokes is batting on 2 from 50, and even the next day it was 3 from 67.
Yeah.
So it's
in fact the other guy I think who was batting with him.
At stumps.
At Joe stumps. Root. Joe Root, yeah. No, after Joe
Root fell, then Bairstow came. They put up an 86-run partnership between them.
Yeah.
And usme se 50 run Ben Stokes hi mara tha. Because ye to 32 pe out ho gaya Bairstow.
But Bairstow aur iska score same tha beech mein. Iska kuch aisa double the balls or something and Bairstow was still like...
Almost.
It is all... See, the thing is that Ben Stokes walked out to bat thinking that I will win come what may.
Yeah.
That I am not concerned about my partner, the opposition bowling.
That was clear.
Because we are not Ben Stokes, so we didn't know this. But when he ran Butler out,
that is supposed
to take a toll on a player. That is supposed to cause guilt. That is supposed to make it hard to move on and face the next ball with a clear mind.
Yeah,
but that did not happen. That just did not happen.
Because wo bahut daru peeta hai.
So this you can lead back to just what he said when he won the World Cup, right? He said, I don't want to be remembered as the guy who punched a dude in a bar.
He said this.
I didn't want this to all end with just...
What are you saying?
Yeah.
And so there was a meme yesterday where the CCTV photo of it and the guy who's punched who's lying down on the floor, they put the Australia cricket board logo onto it.
But I think Australia lost not so much because of anything but really bad captaincy at the end. Everybody was falling, catches were dropping.
It was not just that. It was a delayed response. And when I say delayed, I mean like the response didn't come. It was a delayed response to an uptick in pressure. Because I think Australia went into the fourth innings thinking that, yeah, we will have this in the bag.
Yeah.
And because at any stage,
cash.
Even at the last wicket, Australia were on top.
Yeah.
It was only...
By the time it was...
At which point in the fourth innings was England on top except for the last, when Jack Leach was at the
crease?
When Leach 70. Came onto the crease, within the first few balls, you knew Leach out nahi hone wala hai. Like Leach was constantly... You should have heard that crowd, dude. I had my headphones on and sitting.
What, Leach out nahi aane wala as soon as he came? In his entire innings, he must have played some 12-13 balls.
Yeah, exactly.
16, I think.
Because
eventually.
It was a brilliant strategy na last ball pe to usko de rahe the. Woh aata tha, ek ball face karta tha. Aur ye banda 90 mara hai.
Correct.
Tu samajh raha, ye banda 90 mara hai. To, like,
Leach 90 mara hai.
Nahi re.
Stokes na.
Haan. Kaisa aadmi hai.
Pehle Leach kam maar diya pehle. He's like, the past mara
hai. The ability to bat with the tail is a really good quality.
It's not an underappreciated, but it's a skill often not spoken of.
And it's one of those skills, you know, that we confuse with the skill of getting runs out of the other guy. That's not this. It's not a Dhoni thing ki dusre ko khilaya. Nahi. Ye khud hi pura pressure soak up kar liya. So then
he's modern day cricketer ka like epitome
right now.
A lot of people drew parallels to Brian Lara's 153 in against Australia only fourth innings, where he was, West Indies won by one wicket and he batted with
even Kushal Parera's
if you've not watched it, you should watch it. It's a great, like, if you obviously enjoyed Ben Stokes, what's the harm in watching something that is considered similar to it? Check out Brian Lara's 153 against Australia.
Which year was this?
This was in the mid 2000s.
Oh, then the peak Lara basically.
He hit 400 in 2004.
This year itself, like, we've seen like a great endorsement for like Test cricket with this one, and also like Kushal Parera's.
As soon as I saw clouds as grey as those over the match, I was like, this match is not completing itself. What happened with that?
Kushal Parera. In the previous beginning of the year. The Durban one, do you all know the...
I don't recall it.
He soaked the pressure. South Africa, we talked about this the last podcast.
The last time, right? Yeah, Kushal Parera scored. Like, I think these two innings this year in like one year's time. It's like great endorsement for Test.
It was ironic because while in England there was a great endorsement, in West Indies there was a very poor endorsement. But like, at the same time, you can't have everything be the greatest endorsement of all time.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, West Indies kuch zyada hi chill hai, yaar. Matlab, jo log ka flag mein beach hai, I don't think wo 5 din tikenge.
They dominated world of cricket for some 2 decades or something.
Yeah, but wo time pe unka body zyada better tha na, logo ko pata nahi tha protein khana rehta hai.
Dude, this guy thinks I'm absolute bullshit, man. Like,
to dekhna yaar.
I have a cousin with that surname, bro.
What are you saying? Rasta life?
No, man.
Andheri life.
Andheri.
It was just batsmen really weren't able to convert. You have to admit, like...
The West Indies batsmen.
India West Indies series.
Kemar Roach was the top scorer, no, in the final.
Yeah. So now imagine we don't undermine the most inspired spell of somebody's career just because they are chill as a country. They are not chill. They really don't want to get out like that.
Yeah.
The thing is, the problem with West Indies is that they have their motivation has changed, and I think they need to be compensated fairly. And I have no doubt then that they will challenge for the top spot in world cricket.
I mean, you think the? I don't think it's the monetary thing no, that's stopping
them. Your monetary health, your financial health is a baser criteria than to be champion of the world.
But like now
for many people, and you can't blame them for that.
Like, but they've got like these Ram Naresh Sarwan on the side now to give like a mental coach for the team who's like trying.
Hopefully that helps. But I don't see West Indies cricket solving itself until they have a healthy financial system going.
Why is BCCI?
Because otherwise, you know, you have to constantly go and play everywhere else. Your team chemistry also doesn't build. Because all the players are mercenary players.
And the thing is, this will not solve itself until the big three loosen their hold on ICC.
No, the big three, I to feel are big in are way to demise. Because abhi Olympics are hai, bro. ICC has decided.
ICC has decided.
Bro,
but ICC is the big three. ICC is the big three.
No, but my point is
aiming for 2028.
My point is that they also realize that the only way this sport can grow beyond where it is right now is if more countries get involved. And that is only if the Olympics.
It's currently limited to the Commonwealth.
Yeah,
that's the
it's
problem.
Really sad.
And even within the Commonwealth, it's not that. I mean, you know, it's
yeah, it's
like Canada,
all the, it's
Canada
all,
and all are not playing.
It's not all.
Abhi
the Commonwealth.
Na, England to gaya tha, how many people give a shit about the fact that they won the World Cup?
No one cares.
Exactly.
Nobody cares in England.
Like it's outside of the immediate cricket audience, nobody really cares.
Like I think more Indians cared about the World Cup final than British people.
That is just a game of numbers, bro. Because we are 1.3.
No, but in general,
like,
enthusiasm. They have so many other options, right? England mein log football dekh rahe, footy,
Wimbledon
dekh rahe, Wimbledon dekh rahe.
Sab aur sab sport mein acha kar hi rahe wo log. F1 bhi kar rahe.
So then you have to increase the base of countries.
Okay, but 1 minute. Now since we were discussing the test match through and through, let's discuss now the final day.
Okay.
The final day.
What do you all have things to say? Any
I have
particular?
Several things
okay,
to say.
You start with it.
Ek toh dekho, you have to admit, like most, like this is somebody who is in sublime form, probably the peak of his game.
It's the summer of Ben Stokes.
We shouldn't
say 2019 summer anymore.
It's summer of Ben Stokes.
Ben Stokes year.
The long summer. To be followed by the long winter.
BC is supposed to change to BS, Ben Stokes.
Australia. I feel like it was a captaincy
issue.
My mistake, you guys. I got confused between both
Error
words.
Error and issue.
That's a good word.
So yeah, it was a... and you expect... Like the DRS call, man. It was the worst DRS call you could have taken as a captain.
I agree.
Never just take a DRS call. What are you doing, bro?
That was the worst. And
that's what I said. They were not able to respond to the uptick in pressure.
Twice they were dropped.
That's a classic mistake under pressure.
Yeah, twice they were dropped. Twice they were run. The run out was goofed. Nathan Lyon goofed it so badly. This is a team.
And you spinner. Hai, tere haath se ball spin hoega. Like tu pakad na saale. Tere haath se ball spin ho gaya saale. Tu read nahi kar liya.
So it was just a team not able to take the pressure that was. And I didn't even feel like it was a team thing. It was like a captain thing.
A few individual moments.
Yeah, that a few individuals couldn't hold their shit together, and that's why England took it.
Did Warner drop the catch?
No, Warner didn't. Warner took a gorgeous catch.
Warner has come into this match with buckets in his hand. Let's just be honest about that, because
nahi choda bhi ek do, but
the ones he has taken are ones begrudge someone for not taking.
So no, Ben Stokes, someone dropped him at like
Ben Stokes got
Marcus Harris, I think, like it was.
I have never understood field position names except for like gully and point.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
And so there's a really nice YouTube channel called Cricket Academy or something. I'll get you the name. They do videos on all of this stuff.
Or just Google it. Like,
nahi, dude.
Hey, my problem is not the resource to see where it is. My problem is to remember where it is.
Fine leg bole to pair ke peeche.
I want to hear this explanation.
Explain this to on a podcast to a bunch of people.
Fine leg bole to leg ke peeche, theek hai.
Ekdam wo baju wala, theek hai. फिर उसके बाद
बोले तो लेग स्लिप
लेग स्लिप नहीं
लेग स्लिप अलग होता है फाइन लेग पीछे होता है और
थोड़ा पीछे जो मतलब लेग अंपायर के बाजू में उसे बात करते हैं
अच्छा ठीक है ठीक है
पास कर दे
वो कौन है
वो फाइन लेग है ना
नहीं तू बोला तो
स्क्वायर है ना
स्क्वायर लेग है तो फाइन अच्छा नहीं नहीं अभी अगले हफ्ते मैं भी पढ़ के आता था और चैनल का नाम क्या बताया था बट मेरे को बेसिक बेसिक तो पता ही मतलब थर्ड मैन मेरे को पता है क्यों पता है क्योंकि मैं घटिया फील्डर था और थर्ड मैन पे हमेशा भेजते थे मेरे को उन लोग तू एकदम पीछे जा उधर बॉल आएगा तो आएगा आराम कर
बाय द वे नो नो नन ऑफ आवर लिसनर्स नो दिस बट डुडेजा सेड समथिंग हिलेरियस ऑन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप दैट वी शेयर फॉर दिस शो ही सेड कल मैं इंग्लैंड का जर्सी पहन के खेला बोथ ऑफ अस वन
दे शुड नो मैं क्रिकेट खेला बट ओके हाँ मैं कल क्रिकेट खेला वन बोथ गेम्स एंड देन बेन स्टोक्स वन आई थिंक इट वाज अ डे फॉर न्यू बैलेंस The sponsor
of your feet.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Now let's come back to the drop catch.
The drop catch. Huh. So I think it was a moment of genuinely 2-3 players who were not able to handle the pressure.
Okay.
I feel like I don't know. Maybe I am just imagining things, but Steve Smith not being there, kind of like
it didn't contribute to the final session because Steve Smith being there, he can't do anything as a bowler.
But he did
something to England psyche.
No, I meant as the mentality of the Australian team also when they were fielding. You know, somebody who was there, like you can constantly see Steve helping out with what's going on. Yeah. You know, and I feel like the captain kind of relies on that right now at this point.
एक तो ये Tim Payne को साला हमेशा captaincy मिल जाती है, पता नहीं कहाँ
हमेशा मतलब when since when have you been following his career, bro?
अबे वो कभी अभी
स्कूल में भी देखो टिम पेन को कैप्टन बना दिया था
यार टिम पेन मुझे नहीं पसंद है
आई लव हिम ब्रो द थिंग इज आई बिकेम अ फैन ऑफ हिम द मोमेंट ही स्टार्टेड डूइंग दैट बैंटर अगेंस्ट इंडिया एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया या
दैट वाज ग्रेट
या दैट वाज फन
बट बैंटर के बेसिस पे कैप्टन नहीं ले सकते
हाँ मतलब मैं
बोलता हूँ ऋषभ पंत को कैप्टन बनाना पड़ेगा
मैं बोलता हूँ डेविड वार्नर है स्टीव स्मिथ को बना दो ना अभी हो गया खत्म
डेविड वार्नर इज लीगली नॉट अलाउड टू बी अ कैप्टन एनीमोर ऑफ द ऑस्ट्रेलियन टीम
तो स्टीव स्मिथ को तो बना दो यार
बट ही हैज अ 2 ईयर वेटिंग पीरियड देन ही कैन बिकम कैप्टन
व्हाट आर यू सेइंग डूड
ही कैन बी कैप्टन आफ्टर 2 ईयर्स
दैट्स टू हार्श
What too harsh, bro? I think they're setting a precedent. that it's harsh is agreeable, but they're setting a precedent that if other people caught for similar charges don't follow, Australia has the higher moral ground to be like, guys, I think there needs to be better dealing of this issue.
Yeah. Okay, man. Whatever. But can I say?
I feel like that really played a part because having him on field is unsettling the Australian. Like, is kind of grounding the Australian team and unsettling the
English team.
ओके फाइन
वो आदमी पागल हो गया डूड वो आदमी पूरा टाइम प्रैक्टिस करता है तेरे को पता है उसका आर्टिकल आया था कि वो कॉरिडोर में प्रैक्टिस कर रहा है हाँ 24 घंटा उसके बाजू वाले कोई रूम में रहने को तैयार नहीं है
ये कैसा कंकशन है यार
इट्स बिफोर द कंकशन आल्सो ही वाज लाइक दिस ही इज ड्रिवन टू डू दिस ही वांट्स दिस
या ही जस्ट वांट्स टू
या ही डजंट वांट टू बी नोन एज द गाय हु वाज कॉट फॉर सैंडपेपर गेट
बट ही वांट्स टू बट इवन बिफोर दैट ही ऑलवेज वांट्स टू मिडल द बॉल लाइक ही वांट्स टू बी नोन एज द गाय हु इज द बॉल मिडलर
या ही डजंट वांट टू बी नोन एज द वाइट गाय नेम्ड स्टीव
बट या सो दैट वाज अ ग्रेट गेम लाइक That was a fun game. After that, was the most boring game that I saw was India.
Why is it boring? It was so gorgeous to see us. Did you see the swing on the ball? Have you ever seen Bumrah swing the ball
basically,
like that?
I'll just give you guys some this thing. Basically, Bumrah and everyone posted a photo on Bumrah's
in the pool or the beach or something.
Yeah, Bumrah was wearing a see-through swimming costume,
okay.
And people could see his Bumrah.
His in-swinger.
His in-swinger.
His out-swinger.
Wait. Are we talking nipples or penis?
अरे निप्पल तो दिख ही रहा है ना यार वो तो
यार इंडियन क्रिकेटर पानी में टी-शर्ट के साथ नहीं जाने वाला उसके पास भी
आज रोहित शर्मा जैसे नहीं
उसका पीनिस दिख रहा है
या
उसका पीन दिख रहा है
या या
ओह नो
या या जस्सू दिख रहा है जस्सू
जैसा कोई नहीं
वो फोटो देखने के बाद आई कांट गेट द इमेज आउट इवन व्हेन ही इज टेकिंग अ विकेट
आवर प्रोड्यूसर इज शोइंग अस द फोटो एंड वी आर लुकिंग आल्सो
आई डोंट नो व्हेन यू सी हिम रनिंग इन यू कैन इमेजिन इट
Hey, one second, I'm gonna go and check this out.
It's a work of art.
Yeah.
It should be in the BCCI museum, I think.
Archives. थोड़ा और zoom in कर दे.
Okay, I get it.
तो photo.
नहीं नहीं इतना देखने का नजर जरूरी
है. This is good because until now only women have been pulled up for fashion for faux pas.
Faux pas.
And it's a good thing.
Good thing. But now I can't. Every time Bumrah, मतलब after that I can see his confidence like rise up. Like now that he's running.
Because he got a lot of messages.
Yeah. He's like 6 wicket le liya dekh liya sabne
he's getting messages from people now saying hey man nice dick and all so he's like, yeah, now final insecurity has also been overcome now
that's a dick pic with a filter on
It's the Kohli filter.
Kohli.
So yeah, I just feel. But I want to show you guys something.
But now see, Kohli is not showing his penis. So now, what does that say about their confidence regarding pin pins?
Because Kohli ko pata hai fashion mein kya pehna hai. He's also married to an actress. They
yeah,
know
yeah,
ki
Kohli will show his penis first. Usko brand ka tattoo karna. Fir aayega picture yaar.
But I want to show you guys. I want to show you guys something really freaky, which I've told Abhineet to pull out before this. This is what happened in when basically Ishan Sharma's catch was dropped. Okay, yeah. Abhineet's gonna open it for you guys, and he's gonna show it to y'all. And there's a surprise there about Ishan Sharma's certain thing. Okay, just watch this. Okay,
okay.
After this, no, this is Bumrah's wicket.
Huh.
After this, they're gonna show you something. Is it on 11:20? Yeah. Now look at this catch is gonna get dropped.
And okay, and the catch is dropped.
Now look at Ishan Sharma. What he does with his दांत, that's right, उसका दांत नकली है,
oh shit,
उसका दांत नकली है,
नहीं उसका दांत नकली नहीं है,
oh my god,
उसने क्या,
it's a mouth guard,
yeah it's a mouth guard, people in boxing also wear it,
so why would he wear it while he's bowling, dude, उसका दांत नकली है,
that's a really good question, why would he wear it when he's bowling,
because I thought first it's a mouth guard, but I'm like कौन boxing का mouth guard पहन के, तू थोड़ी boxing का glove yeah, dude, what the hell is that? We can post this on.
Okay, then we will post this along with the episode. This is truly
I
a freaky thing.
I won't be surprised. Uska yeah. daat. Uska awaz iske liye waisa hai ki uska daat nakli hai.
Move hand.
Is he going
move
back?
Move hand is an instruction.
Oh, right there. It was right there on right the moment.
Yeah.
It's happening again. Move hand
is an instruction Aakash has not given for the first time.
That's what I tell my variety.
Okay, anyway, we had a long cricket segment as well. We head into a break and come back with what is going to be a very difficult wow and now.
Yes, especially with this year.
So there's lots to look forward to. Let's see you after the break.
Wow and now.
Hi, my name is Anupam Gupta. I'm B50 on Twitter. I am the host of Paisa Paisa, the show that talks money. On my show, I speak to experts from every field of money and finance, from stock markets, equities, debt funds, credit cards, life insurance, every possible area of money and finance that you can think of. We even did an episode on cryptocurrency. I've got fantastic guests from mutual funds to personal finance experts everywhere, robo-advisory startups, just name it, we've got it. At Paisa Paisa, we help you make smart decisions about money. You work hard for money. Now make your money work hard for you. New episodes out every Monday, and you can listen to my show on the IVM Podcast app or any other podcasting app that you have.
Welcome back to the third segment of the Waddaplayah podcast that is called
Wow and Now.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, be wow. Pehle now kar lete. Now.
Not a player of the week.
Tim Payne.
No, Tim Payne. I thoroughly disagree with Tim Payne, man.
Nathan Lyon.
One second. May I show you
Okuhara?
May I back this up?
No, the 1 minute. The Noddaplayah is not an award for losing.
Okay.
The Noddaplayah is an award for
being call.
Yeah, like extraordinarily. And Waddaplayah is an award for being extraordinarily good.
How about making 11 runs in the first innings and then going on to make a massive total of 0 in the second innings, and then fudging a DRS, and then getting the wrong bowler to bowl the damn thing, and
which
then just being generally frazzled. Nathan Lyon kyun dal raha hai? Ben Stokes ko. Tum log IPL nahi dekha hai? Ye kha jata hai unko.
But
जो पागल है तुम लोग
बट अंपायर को भी दे सकते
हैं अंपायर
ने क्या गंदा
कॉल दिया बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट द फर्स्ट टाइम दिस अंपायर हैज फक्ड अप ही इज ऑलरेडी अ प्रीवियस रेसिपिएंट ऑफ द Noddaplayah and he was the first
non-player. When was this?
I don't know if you were there, but Aakash and me definitely gave it to him.
After the first test. Because they were like, but we had that time we had given to both umpires because generally it was dismal umpiring.
Yes, but this is one call.
But it is two runs required.
One minute.
And he's out. I want to have
this discussion. Do you see the sport going towards digital umpiring? Because the fact is, the two biggest results of this year so far have been determined by by umpiring errors.
I agree.
And that cannot be the case, man. Like, you cannot have the greatest advertisement for your sport, yeah, have also the worst advertisement for your sport.
I will then allow you to add him as a nominee. Okay?
Okay.
No, but I'm also making a point on this discussion. Yeah, like, do you all see it going that way?
No, I totally think like it should be digitalized. And umpire ko rakho as a paisa waisa do aesthetic ke liye rakho.
The traditional argument is that this is the tradition of the sport, that you respect the word of the umpire. And you know what? When that was the case, the umpires did not feel as much pressure and the decisions tended to be more right than they are in the current age, where a player can review it and it turns out to be right, because I'm sure that plays on the umpire's ego, that makes him unsure, right? Because you don't have decision job security.
Yeah.
And if that's going to be the case, then do away with the umpire completely, right? Because
but I think like watches, they should be there as accessory to like just be there.
There is
look good. And maybe dance in them. Like, we can get some entertainment out of them.
Watch, if you want to watch how referees are treated, the best, I feel, example is NBA and NFL.
Yeah.
Where they are constantly berated, they are constantly shat on, and their job is the kind of job where they are incentivized to be right.
Yeah.
So their pay is directly related to how much of the percentage of right calls that they make. And what happens here is, a lot of times umpires tend to go to the third umpire because they know ki I genuinely don't know.
Yeah, matlab that run out also smart. There was one run out that I saw and I'm like, ye to out hai, third umpire ke paas.
No, run out, it was many decades ago. It was said mandatory to refer run outs.
Yeah.
Unless you're 5 bat lengths away.
Yeah.
So, no, but okay, cool.
So, the idea here is ki then the umpire on the ground is likely to go up whenever required, because he knows that if he's wrong and the third umpire shows that it's the other way, he's going to get his ass kicked and he's going to have to sit for a meeting. And
perhaps that is a good.
But then what if
solution?
He'll take a call by himself and not go to the third umpire, because that could also be a deterrent.
But why would run up? Because if then the third umpire can still see na ki kya tha wo. And if
but
he then, sees that it's horribly off.
Yeah. No, Akash is saying is that the umpire is now no longer incentivized to give a decision when he's not sure.
Yeah, but my point is, it could also be a deterrent where if he won't go into the third umpire, he'll just give a decision.
Then his pay is cut, right? Like, he has something to lose in that situation.
Okay, yeah, we could do that. Yeah, like match fees katna chahiye.
Haan, umpire ka bhi match fees katna chahiye. Dude, referee agar baitha hai udhar, to kaato na.
Yeah, that was a terrible
decision. At least internally,
and the thing is,
par yaar, ye wahi baat hai na. Dekh, I mean, I completely agree with you. It was a terrible decision, but it's like one of those act of God situations. Barish gira to gira. As a captain, you have to plan for what is in front of you.
Yes, as I said with the World Cup, the 5 runs that were wrongly awarded cannot be undone. And England cannot stand to lose this match once the game is over.
Oh yeah.
But now we are seeing a pattern that in situations of pressure, the pressure gets to the umpire as well.
Hmm. No, I was saying in context of Noddaplayah. So I think Timpen f***ed up more than the umpire is what I'm trying to say.
Okay, cool. So we have both nominees from Aakash for Noddaplayah of the week. Do you have a nominee?
I think the umpire definitely more than Timpen also. Because Timpen,
Of one call.
Yeah, because that was
a really
clear
important call.
That
man.
Was
like, if one call can reverse a situation, like not even like change a situation, it didn't make it a tie.
Imagine Australia winning by one run.
Yes,
but like then, it would have.
No, imagine Timpen also made that one call only that he. You know what I'm trying to say? He
also goofed up
more than one call.
I think Nathan Lyon like was too aggressive on that call to Timpen. So I would still.
Did Nathan Lyon call for the call?
Nathan Lyon was a little too aggressive.
Bro,
on the calling.
I was watching it live. It was clearly a sense of, ha, chalo, dal do. It was not a.
It was throwing a tantrum.
It was not even a tantrum. It was just, ki, ha, dal do, dekh le, ho gaya to kya. It was like, fucking, they had already lost.
They
had already lost in their heads.
Yeah.
Timpen had lost in his head.
It was written all over Nathan Lyon's face, if not the Australian team.
Yeah, he was too aggressive on that call, and I'm like, dude, ye ball bahut dur ja raha hai. Clearly. But main umpire ko fir bhi de dun, aur Timpen maybe not. I think Nathan Lyon ko dusre zyada, to usne to run out bhi miss kar diya.
Okay, so
aur usne kafi aggressive
call
diya.
I think we have a consensus, but then it's going to be a unique situation. I see both of y'all have nominated both. And you have nominated Timpen more than the umpire, and he has nominated the umpire more than Timpen.
Yes.
I am nominating the umpire more than Timpen, but we will have two victors of the Noddaplayah.
Yes.
But like it's the umpire is still the major winner of this.
Why? Abhinit, what do you think?
Hey, he doesn't get a vote, bro.
Why doesn't he get a vote?
He doesn't
if
get
there
a
is
vote.
Clear. No, no, of course he does.
It's a host determined vote. The guests when you guys have not been there.
Fine. Allow me to ask him as his off the record opinion.
Why are we asking Bangladesh who they want our prime minister to be? What is this very question?
Just because he's Northeastern doesn't mean he's Bangladesh.
He's very Bengali, bro.
That also doesn't mean he's Bangladeshi.
Yeah. Tim thinks it's Tim Payne.
Okay, so Bangladesh,
just for the record,
Bangladesh thinks someone else should be the prime minister. Who the f*** cares, right?
Okay then.
So it is the primary
winner. How about we ask our recording engineer today who he thinks should be the Noddaplayah player of the week? Will you also ignore him?
The primary winner is Joel Wilson and the secondary winner is Tim Payne. Yeah. Although they are both winners.
Yes.
As is procedure, please come to car station.
Yeah.
And call us when you get here. We'll tell you how to come.
How, yeah.
And now for the Waddaplayah.
Waddaplayah, many options. Wada. Many thoughts.
I think I know what Dudeja and me are going to agree
Matthew
on.
Matthew Waddaplayah. Okay, no.
Dude, it makes great marketing to have him be Waddaplayah.
Yeah.
Waddaplayah.
Can I start? Yeah. Can I start a dukan Vada Pav ka and call it Matthew Waddy? Like Jumbo King, Matthew Waddy.
If one of us can't do it, one of the listeners, please make a graphic or meme of Matthew Waddy.
Bolo Matthew Waddy.
Okay.
Why is this shop on the go where he's going to housing society and calling out to people? Vada shop is usually in one place.
No, but he's a mobile. Sports, yeah.
He
can't go to a desk job.
So here's the thing, okay? I have my message ringtone is a 50 cent laugh because everyone's message tone tends to be the same and everyone checks their phone at the same time. So Dureja, can you do that Matthew Waddy again so that our recorders can make that their ringtone if they feel so?
Okay. You all want the Bolo Matthew Waddy?
Yeah. Bolo Matthew Waddy. 1, 2.
Bolo Matthew Waddy.
That should be Matthew Waits. Ringtone right there.
Now you started. So I'll
now you start.
My nominee is PV Sindhu.
PV Sindhu.
World champion. And not just world champion. World champion in a fucking dominant manner.
And how? See, I have always had soft corner for PV Sindhu.
Yes,
so
you have.
I would have expressed it earlier. Yeah. So I would say PV Sindhu.
Yes.
Yeah.
Are you saying PV Sindhu, Ben Stokes?
I'm saying absolutely PV Sindhu. But I feel like there are some honourable mentions.
Yeah, of course there are. Yes,
Ben
yes,
Stokes,
for
Bumrah,
sure.
Ajinks we didn't even discuss.
Ajinks got his 100 after 28 innings or something.
Yeah, and 2 years.
And 2 years.
A long dry run and also an 80 in the second inning. So like,
first inning 81, second inning 81.
And
I think,
finally.
So okay, so
without a doubt, PV Sindhu.
PV Sindhu is the
catch a local, get to car station.
Yeah.
You're the one person we can actually expect.
And
the honourable mentions are Ben Stokes,
Jinx, absolutely.
Ajinkya Rahane.
Jasprit also took a lot.
Jasprit.
Ishan Sharma took a 5.
Yeah,
5-4.
5-4 and Bumrah took a 6.
But I mean, we can't have honourable mentions for everyone who's done well.
No.
Like,
I'm saying
Liverpool also defeated Arsenal 3-1.
Three honourable mentions. Okay, Jinx for finding form. Stokes for the summer that he's in.
Yeah.
And Bumrah, because did you watch that ball swing?
Yeah, it was too.
Okay,
but even Ishan Sharma's like.
Nahin, but Bumrah pehli bar kiya na.
Bumrah.
Like it's, I just saw it happen. Like it, it's like we all. Like
koi baat nahi yaar. Abhi uska chaddi mein hole tha. Usko encouragement chahiye. Apan
Jasu nahi jaisa koi nahi.
Bumrah, if you want, you can come to Khar Station. You will not get the same prize, but we will hang out with you.
But just don't also wear the see-through swimsuit.
Also great dong. Yes.
Yeah.
Proud of you, beta.
And this applies to you as well, Ben Stokes, and you as well, Jinx.
Jasu's giving internet from his dongle. No. Okay. He's an internet provider.
But just to recap, the Waddaplayah is PV Sindhu and the Noddaplayah is Joel Wilson, first and second Tim Payne.
Yeah,
it's been quite an episode, guys. Great fun to record this episode. You can catch us on the IVM network and the IVM network itself is on all social.
Pakadle apne ko.
The IVM network itself is on all social all social media handles. And if you want to listen to any of us, you can catch Aakash at
You can catch me at Kujbi Mehta or not Kujbi Mehta.
At Siddharth Dudeja Insta, at Sid Dudeja Twitter.
And you can catch me at Almeida Mikhail on Insta and Mikhail Almeida on Twitter. Until next time, we will see you soon. But 1 minute, Aakash has something to say.
The other podcast I do is back, guys. Vartalab is back on the IVM network. You can check it out on the podcast app or any of your, wherever you get your podcast, we are back. You should listen to it.
What is the podcast about? It's a
storytelling based podcast. We get a lot of people from a lot of different walks of life. And Naveen Narayan and I.
ऐसा स्टोरी आएगा, लोग बोलेंगे मैं बंदर मेरा टोपी लेके गया, टोपी मेरे को वापस नहीं दे रहा है, मैं सोचा कैसे वापस लूं, फिर मैं पत्थर फेंका नीचे, फिर वो टोपी आ गए. That's the vibe. That's the vibe of the show. It's a story.
Aesop's fables.
It's a storytelling podcast. And Aakash hosts it.
And with Naveen Narona.
Yes, you should definitely check that out. And until then, we will see you next week and keep in touch. And if you can make that Matthew Wade meme, please,
man, we want to see it. Yeah. One more time for the crowd.
Bolo Matthew Wade.
This is the amazing story of something awesome. Once Chuck decided to start a podcast, and so he did. The end. Okay, that was a crappy story. But I've got some really cool stories over at my new show, The Origin of Things. On this podcast, I look at the stories of how brands came into being and sometimes evolved out of quite unexpected circumstances. And to make it really fun, I reveal the name of the brand and sometimes a category only at the very end. The show is 5 to 7 minutes per episode and perfect for trivia junkies and brand nerds, especially those with short attention spans. New episodes out every Wednesday on IVM Podcast app or website or any podcast app or site that you happen to prefer. End of story, they lived happily ever after.
Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Careers in the new podcast series presented by Accenture. I'm your host, Shiladitya Mukhopadhyay. In this podcast series, we'll get you the latest and greatest in the world of technology that's shaping the future of business as we know it. We're talking intelligent platforms, cloud, AI, blockchain, extended reality, and a whole lot more. Every fortnight on Wednesdays, we'll have for you a hot topic with expert speakers from Accenture talking about top trends in the space, how these are changing the world and creating growth across industries. And importantly, we'll tell you how you can learn more, build your skills and expertise to grow and stay relevant in your career. Episodes out on the IVM Podcast app or wherever you get your podcasts from.